How important is education to you guys?
Stupid important, dude.
Stupid important.
I think education is more important than like
sex,
water,
school education.
No, I think just learning.
Just learning in general. But yeah, but school education.
And
you know that Chinese kid that's going viral? He's trying to like get the all the fucking book.
Oh, is that what he's doing?
Spreading into his eyes.
Dude, we seen some crazy shit from China.
You like, there's this that one, the speed reading?
I think education is everything.
It is,
dude.
Man.
Like, the older I get, the more I understand the word, the phrase knowledge is power.
But Game of Thrones says power is power.
True.
Who said that?
The best.
Who's the best?
Cersei.
But she died.
Badass.
Yeah, she did die, so.
Because she
knowledge
died.
Is power.
By the sword of knowledge, yeah.
Well, there was a thing.
Well,
that,
season 8 was
yeah,
the dumbest.
Yeah, but you could have moved over
way.
Here.
Season 8 was just a dumb.
That was
dumb
so dumb. Dude, like.
Okay, I'm sorry. I opened
the
up this
it was the lazy writer's way.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like, I'm tired of this shit.
I fucked up the debate, sorry. But yeah, knowledge is power.
I think education is just tremendously important, even if it's fake as fuck.
Fake as fuck? But.
Why? How does that work?
Well, okay. So think about a country that is like fucked up, but they have really good education for that people. It's there's order, there's less crime, there's just everything that's more like, I mean, it's not good for the individual, of course, because they're like brainwashed and shit. For the average citizen, I'm talking about.
Which country are you talking about?
North Korea.
North Korea.
I think it depends.
Re-education is bad.
I'm just kidding.
On what education you get. Because there's obviously like,
yeah, what is education, right? It's all relative, right? True. Like, yeah, but
like,
yeah,
you should like, never stop learning. You shouldn't stop learning. There's things that you should question. But I feel like the more you know, not just knowing is like people like, say you know what's going on with the world, I feel like now you're dumber because you're so stressed about things that don't actually impact your life. But then there's this shit that you learn in school that none of us use ever.
There's so much useless
but
shit.
But then if you think about it, right, okay, what... When is there ever, I don't think there's a stat that exists where high educated populations have a high crime rate and high like low quality of life for the citizens. It's usually a correlation of high education and good quality of life. So I think like in order to get that, you need an educated populace to have a, you know, good country or
very
good
true,
area.
Very true. So yeah, so that brings to this article, retired ADM dot is admiral, right? In the military?
ADM dot, I guess, I don't
yeah.
know.
That's retired like Admiral William McRaven. He's a former US Navy SEAL commander and head of the US Special Operations Command.
Wow.
He's pretty fucking up there.
He's
and
a badass.
He's saying K-12 education, K-12 education is super vital to US national security.
Hell yeah, dude.
US national security.
Why?
So I agree.
Yeah.
You got so many dumbasses running around. Look at how bad it is.
Well, why is it the national security?
To quote, unless we are giving opportunity and a quality education to the young men and women in the United States, then we won't have the right people to be able to make the right decisions about our national security. So he's trying to pave the way for the future generations of our country. And he's saying, within the U.S., we haven't really developed a culture of education.
Yeah. Hell no, so people make fun of education here because they're like, you're a fucking nerd, you're stupid, yeah, like.
Yeah, because I think like a way to explain it would be like, let's say you're trying to explain calculus to someone, right? And it takes, you gotta go start with algebra, then you gotta go to algebra 2, and then like geometry, all that stuff. So the closer you are to calculus, the easier it is to implement calculus, right? But if you have to start them
From arithmetic,
you're fucked. So I think what he's saying is like, when you're talking about like politics at a global level, you're dealing with calculus. But if everyone's at a first grade
which is
happening now with a lot of the crazy shit that's going on, it's like, okay, how the fuck do I even start the conversation? Because I need to bring you up to speed so you know what the hell I'm talking about before we can even work together. And so I think for him, that's why it's a national security issue, because we got to bring people up to speed so people can make good decisions together.
I was thinking it was on the sense of, you look what's happening in the Middle East, the people that aren't educated are the ones that are easily to convince of.
That's exactly it though. That's exactly, because if those are like first graders, right? They're just going, I just want my candy. And you're like, you don't get it. Candy over 10 years is going to rot your teeth. And they're like, what's 10 years? You know, so I think for
them. Isn't that what they do with the military?
What do you mean?
Well, they're like, oh, like, we'll pay for your school, we'll pay for this, you'll get like a job after to join the military.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So you gotta get people brought up so people make good decisions together and not impulsive decisions.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah, like the more the older I get to, oh shit, this laptop's about to die. The older I get, like, I think I've realized there's a lot of people that really, based on how they're brought up, it carries over into how they conduct themselves as adults and how they raise their children. And it's like, it's just a never ending cycle if we don't have more of an opportunity for different types of people to get into the mindset of like education is power, you know what I mean? And like, I think of what you're saying, like it's just, there's a lot of people that really don't value it. And I think we're in an era too where there's so many opportunities like with social media and things like that to just make a living off of like out of nothing really.
Yeah.
And it's really diminished the necessity for education in people's minds.
Well, I think it's also, cause it's like, what are we actually learning? Cause then I feel like I'm better off and I failed a lot of my classes, you know, like there's people that I know that ace all their classes, went to school, but they're dumb because they have a limited worldview. They don't know how to do shit. They spent 20 years or however long for all this education to know one thing that they're not even using. And then now they think they're smarter than everyone and they don't want anything because, or they can't humble themselves to get something else because they think they're better than other people.
Right.
So I think I used to think like that too. But now I do believe in at least some core competencies that people all must have. Cause like for you, right? You're extremely smart. You know a lot about a lot of things, right? But the problem is, I think when 10 people speak 10 different languages, it's really hard to work together. So I think at least half of the things that you need to know, if the whole nation, at least 50% of what they need to know is on the same page, they can at least have and start the same conversation, then everyone can have all the stuff that they want to learn.
I just think that like with how we're teaching people now, that's not what we're doing.
Yeah.
Well, I think that's what he's talking about is reform and focusing on making better. Because our education hasn't really changed since they started this structure.
It has changed. I tutor Isaac.
What I mean by change, fucking math.
Dude.
What I mean like, by change though is the invention of education hasn't, like the way that we have it, it's during the Industrial Revolution, which is over 100 years old, right? And then the structure hasn't changed of it. Unless you go to a special school, like Waldorf or something like that, that's completely different. But the system hasn't changed, and I think that needs to be completely different.
I think that, the educational system should just be like the students that go to it. You should always be learning and changing and adapting to whatever it is. But I'm actually like, I'm a big like proponent of traditional education, because even though there are subjects that you don't feel like you need, I feel like even as you learn things that aren't gonna have to, like, it doesn't directly correlate with what you're gonna do in your future, I feel like it always teaches you a little bit of something, right? It teaches you about how something works or how to think, or like how to think critically about things that don't matter to you. I think that's important too.
I think kind of like the Bible or like any religion or whatever, right? I don't think the subject is what's at fault. I think it's the way that it's taught that it's at fault. Mm-hmm. Like algebra, understanding how to solve an equation when you have like one missing variable and there's two other things, that concept is really important for people to learn to be able to critically think. But if you have a boring ass fucking teacher, you're just not gonna do good.
Yeah,
but that concept,
that skill is
extreme. And same thing with history, with all the things across the board, like those concepts are really important, but how it's taught isn't the most effective way.
That's true.
Yep.
Yeah, and then like this Admiral guy, he kind of pinpoints certain communities too within the country that a lot of residents think they can't afford higher education, or that they think that their children aren't smart enough. So there is like this invisible ceiling.
Yeah,
that,
I came
that
from that school of thought.
Coming, yeah.
Yeah.
But then how'd you break out of that? Because I think that's kind of like, I don't know if there's a whole lot of reform we can even do really, because there seems to be like a more of an attitude thing towards education. Yeah, and it's coming from the parents and the household. And then we, as children, we learn that, oh, my mom can talk back to the teacher. My mom will always have my back. And when you kind of lose that respect for the teacher, you kind of lose all sorts of respect for higher learning. You know what I mean? So how'd you break it?
I think it's a balance. Well, I'm fortunate enough that I had family members that went to higher learning education. I think that played a huge role, like you said, like family, right? So like, even though my environment was like that and it was confirmed by my friends and everyone around me, like, oh yeah, college is only for geniuses and like smart people, like that's not for us, right? I think by having someone in proximity that's been to college, you have a higher likely of going, like higher chance. Like my brother went, whatever, right? So it's like, oh yeah, I guess it could be done. Yeah, yeah. Whereas like a lot of my schoolmates, like their parents, some of them didn't even go to school. Like they just came to this country. Or like some of them, like their parents were in gangs and they never passed the sixth grade or whatever. So that environment plays a big role, but also I don't think people understand how fucked up the inner city school is because, for example, like just me coming into Monterey Park from Gardena, like it's like coming from a high school that didn't really have books for all the students, like that's even unheard of. That sounds like a fucking poor ass country. Like we're in America and the students don't all have books. What the fuck, right? That's weird.
That's true.
Overcrowded classrooms of over 40 students, like that's weird. Like that kind of shit is like, we're shielded.
Yeah.
Because if you go to a school out here in the San Gabriel Valley, and if you compare it maybe to San Marino, they'll be like, oh, poor kids in San Gabriel Valley. But they don't really know what real poor is like in America. Right. So when he's talking about like, we need to focus on education, I think he's talking about we need standardized education where whether you're poor or rich, you get access to the same quality. Because the poor neighborhoods don't get access to the same quality.
That way we could all speak the same language.
Yeah, because it's funded by the taxes, you know what I mean? And if it's an underserved or underprivileged community, then what taxes are going to the school?
I also saw this one video that this guy was talking to, I think it was like Syracuse, New York or something. So it's like, or somewhere, I'm not too sure exactly what's happening, but the guy was explaining like, okay, like 95% of the people that work here don't work in the city. Right, so they make all this money from the city, but then they go and they pay taxes in their own communities, in their own suburbs, the richer places.
They stimulate the economy elsewhere.
Outside, yeah. And then they come back and none of the money is ever being put back into the community, but they're coming and taking their money and just funding their own. You know, and then they don't have to do anything because they come here and they're not doing anything for the community. It's impoverished, but they always talk about how they're
trying to change
it.
The teachers are just different workers.
Yeah.
Or are you talking about teachers or different workers?
No, this was within the government itself. So then they're questioning that, but that makes sense in terms of just like how like these places that people work for, like the people that work for that community or that school are trying to make it better, they don't live in that city either. Yeah. So they're taking the money outside of that.
That's an argument they're making for a bunch of other staff too, like teachers.
Yeah.
Like teachers should live in the community that they serve, even police officers. Like don't live here when you're policing over there, like you treat them as if they're like outside people, like you should be like protecting your own home. Like,
that's a good point. Politicians,
like it's a big argument they're making across the board. Like everyone should be serving their community so you have your community's best interest in mind. Not, oh, I'm gonna buy a house here. This is my real city over here. I'm just going here to lock up bad guys.
Right. And just make a paycheck.
Yeah.
That's a really good point.
That is a good point. Yeah, it's pretty hard to fix the whole world. But I do believe like general education, like I always talk shit about the school system. But it's not because I'm against education and general education.
Oh, true. Yeah, because for a lot of years you've kind of talked so much shit about education and like you don't need to go to school.
That's
all
I'm saying.
College.
Like I used to think the way Nadine thinks, but I think at least 50%. I'm kind of like more with Nelson now, where I'm like, at least people need to speak the same language, so we need to have a general standard of what everyone needs to be at, so we can have. So we don't just have like conversations where like this person sounds crazy to this person sounds crazy to this person. We're never gonna achieve any solution.
And when JK was saying like fuck college, it was never to not learn. It was like the way the school system does it and what it prioritizes is broken.
Yeah, they prioritize like, money making.
Exactly. So that's what was always being preached at JK since like fucking 10, well, however long we've been standing. But like the point has always been pursue your passions and educate yourself in that. Be enriched in that and then grow from that. That was always a message.
Yeah, I think like when we're talking about becoming rich, it's hard to be rich going through the traditional route and becoming highly successful. You got to do things that are unordinary or just against the grain, right? But to build a great nation, you need general education for the general public. And you need everyone to be literate. You need everyone to have basic skills and just normal fucking critical thinking of skills, you know? So, yeah.
Education is power.
Yep.
And you'll know what I'm talking about if you ever do an escape room and you got that one dumbass homie. Everyone's trying to do this and this motherfucker's like, no, you just gotta smell the colors, man. And you're like, God damn it.